Hello friends, this is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. We saw how we can use HQL in Hibernate in previous video tutorial, and we had written HQL with having clause, and we ran this example and we got the actual output, right? So if there are a lot of queries, basically HQL queries, if you're writing within your application queries, basically when you scattered throughout the application, then this HQL is sometimes very difficult to manage, right? So if there are a lot of queries, right, then they will cause a code mesh, because all the queries will be scattered throughout the project, and that's why Hibernate provides named query that we can define at a central location and use them anywhere in the application. We can create named queries for both HQL as well as native SQL query. In this video tutorial, we'll see how we can define a named query for HQL. Hibernate named query can be defined in Hibernate mapping file or through the use of JPA annotations. Annotation is called add named query. The add named query annotation is used to specify a HQL query, and that can be retrieved later by its name. Add named query has a two parameters. First parameter is the name of query itself, and second is the HQL query, right? So let's go ahead and try to learn how we can define a named query in Hibernate. So to show this demo, basically I'm taking this example which just we had learned in the previous video tutorial. There we have written this HQL, right? And there we have seen how we can get total salary, sum of salaries by department ID, right? And for that we had written this HQL query with having clause. So what I'll do, I'll copy this project and I'll make another copy of this project with some different name. I'll give the name as named query in Hibernate example, right? And let me close the previous project. So I'm going to close this project, and now this is the project which just we have created from our existing project. Once you download this project from the GitHub, then only you will have to run this client program, and that client program is called a save data client test, and this will create these two tables in your test database. Make sure that you are specifying the database name as test. Then this is going to create a two tables, first department, and this will create a two department, and in employee table this is going to insert five records, right? And you'll get data will be populated like this. And now we have another client program saying that HQL with having clause. So let me rename this class as well. Here I would say named query in Hibernate test. So here I'm going to show you how we can use named query, right? Now you can see here I have written the HQL here itself. So what I'll do, I'll cut this HQL, and this named query usually we define before our entity class. So you might have a lot of entity class, but here we want to get the total salaries by department ID. So here a salary, we want to get the employee ID for all employees, right? So that's what I'm going to write a named query before this entity class, right? So I would say named query, and this is one of the JP annotations. So when you go for the auto support, then you can see there are two annotations. First is the named queries, and second is the named query. So if you have only single named query, then you should go for the named query. If you have multiple named queries, then you may use add named queries, and within the named queries you can define a lot of named query. So let's go for the singular one which defines only one named query. So at named query, and the first parameter is the name of the query, and second is the query itself. Now here I'm going to write a name of the query, get total salary by get total salary of employees by DEPT department, right? And here that SQL is just I had copied from my client program, just I have pasted over here, and that's it, you are done. Now thing is that in here in client program, how we can retrieve this named query. So this named query you can retrieve by this name itself, and this name would be the unique for your entire application. If you are going to define another named query with the same name, then in application startup itself Hibernate is gonna throw an error, right? So session factory will not be created. So that's the fails fast basically. Now come here, and here I will have to use another API which is present in the session interface, and that is called get named get named queries, right? And here of course you will have to pass this name of this query, that's it, and you are done, and rest of the code would work as it is. Now after doing this modification, let's run this application, and here you'll get the result. Now you can see SQL is converted into the corresponding SQL, and you got the department name IT management, which is having total salary greater than 2 lakhs, and this is running perfectly fine. Now here if you come to the employee, then we have currently only one named queries. Sometimes you have a more than one named queries, then that's what Hibernate provides, or JPA provides. Another annotation is called named queries, that's a plural of named query, and inside this you can go and you can have a many named queries. So here we have already one named query. So this named query, just I'm going to cut and paste it over here, and after that we'll have to put the comma. So every named query should be separated with the comma. Now next named query, so here I'm going to write another named query. Let's suppose I would say name of the query, I'm going to specify employee dot by ID. So that's the naming convention basically. Here you can specify the any name. So here I have given the entity class name and saying that by ID. So this is clear indication I want to get the employee information based on the ID. And here I'm going to write a SQL from employee where employee ID equal to, either you can write a question mark placeholder, or you can write a named parameter. So I'm gonna write a named parameter as well, right? Now this you can retrieve this SQL by this query name. Now I come to here in client program, and here I'm gonna refactor this code. So let me refactor this code, and I would say get total salary of employees by DEPT department, right? So that's the functionality we have implemented in this method. So that's what I have given the name like this. Now let me create another method, and I'm going to copy this method and I would paste it over here, and here I'm gonna specify the method name as get employee by ID, right? So get employee by ID, and in here EMP ID, that's nothing but the employee ID, I'm going to specify as 2. So this employee ID we were supposed to get from the client. Now a lot of things, unnecessary code I'm going to remove, and here your query name is employee dot by ID. So we can retrieve this SQL by this name, and at this time this guy is going to return you employee itself, right? So query of employee. Now let's import it. That is another package, and you may call unique result method, and actually this is going to return us employee object, right? So we can print employee information, right? And you can, sorry, employees information, not employee ID. Now you can go to the employee class, and here we can override two string methods so that a state of object will be printed in the nice format. So let's override two string method, and here we have overridden two string method. Now let's go ahead and run this application. Now we'll have to call this method, right? So let's call to this method and make sure that we are able to retrieve this query by this name, right? Which just we have written at the entity level, and this HQL gets converted into the SQL. But before running this application, this HQL is having one named parameter, so of course you need to supply value for that. And query is having a set parameter, so you have a lot of overloaded set parameter method. So I'm gonna use this one, which first string, first parameter is a string, and second is object itself. So this string is nothing, name of the parameter. So name of the parameter, we have given empid, and value employee id, value client has to send, right? So that we are setting over here, and that's it, we are done. Now if I run it, then we should be able to get the employee information based on the provided id, right? Now you can see we got the employee's information, right? So employee whose id is 2, employee name is Nidhi. So if you go to the database, you can verify employee whose id is 2, her name is Nidhi itself, right? So I hope you understood how named query you can define before your entity class. So this is the central location, right? So of course this will reduce the maintenance. So if anybody new developer comes in your team, then they know. So most of the queries you have collected, and you have basically you have declared before the your entity class, and so they can go before the entity class and they can find all the query at one place and they make change. So some of the important points regarding Hibernate named query, like Hibernate named query helps us in grouping queries at central location rather than letting them scattered all over the code. Hibernate named query syntax is checked when the Hibernate session factory is created, thus making the application fail fast in case of any error in the named queries. So if you make any mistake while writing the named query, so that will be identified in the application startup itself rather than later point of time. Now Hibernate named query is global, means once defined it can be used throughout the application. One of the major disadvantage of named query is that it's hard to debug because we need to find out the location where it is defined, right? Still there is some problem. We have a lot of entity classes, right? So if particular named query where you have defined, that will have to, of course, you need to find. But anyway, rather than scattering this SQL throughout your application, putting it before the entity class would be preferable. So that's all I wanted to show in this video tutorial, guys. So this code I'm going to check in on the GitHub, and GitHub location you'll get in the video description itself. In next video tutorial, we are going to see how get named native query works. So here, as I said in beginning itself, so named query you can define for the HQL as well as SQL or native query as well. So in next video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to define a named query for plain SQL query. So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.